few entertainers can say that they have made the impact that our next guest has. From the stage to movies to television, Ben Vereen is truly a renaissance man. Welcome, Ben. We're so excited to have you here.
I'm so happy to be here.
You renaissance man.
Aww. I was listening to him as you
Thank
spoke.
You.
He was like, oh.
Oh, you have done it all.
No, that's not me.
Let's start with your stage career. Now, once you said that was your training ground.
It is my training ground, and it is still my training ground, even working. I'm going to say hello, first of all, to my people in Venice, at the Venice Theater, you know, to all my people out there who gave me the opportunity last year to do the hair and that wonderful experience. That is a training ground for me because of the fact that it teaches you discipline. Mm-hmm. It teaches you focus. It teaches you determination. It teaches you, you know, to get your act together, you know? Yeah. And so it has been a real training ground for me. And that foundation has stayed with me and allowed me to open up my eyes to life. And that's what I try to teach when I work with younger people.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's amazing.
Well, you started out big time when you started. We remember, of course, Pippin. It won Tony Awards.
Yeah,
it was, amazing.
Yeah, see, you're talking about all the stuff that people know.
Oh, so there was something I don't know.
Oh, there was more?
Something happened before Pippin?
Before Pippin's.
Oh, sure,
you know,
a little clip.
It was right out of the High School of Performing Arts. I got the opportunity to work with Vinette Carroll.
Wow.
And she was directing a play called The Prodigal Son. And I met a guy named Langston Hughes.
Langston Hughes?
Who became a good buddy of mine.
Wow.
And he took me to Harlem for the first time and sat me down and talked me about the Renaissance of Harlem. Yeah, so that was my start.
Ah.
And then from there, some guy came along and said, I saw you at the High School of Performing Arts. I'm doing a little show in a place called Tannersville, Pennsylvania. It's called Summer Stock.
Uh-huh.
I went, okay, what's a Summer Stock? Yeah. And then he took me out to Summer Stock, and they were doing West Side Story. And I'd seen West Side Story, because they used to run with gangs in Brooklyn. So I said, yo, I can do this. And so then they started dividing up the part, and the guy, they had this guy, this white guy was playing Riff. And I said, I can play Riff. They said, Ben, he's Polish. I said, I can be Polish. What's with that?
That's when you knew
Come
you
on,
do
diversity,
any part.
You're an actor, yes.
It's called the arts.
Yeah. Oh, the arts. Now, that reminds me of Roots. That was one of the defining moments in the arts, I think, in this country. The first miniseries that I ever remember. Mm-hmm. What an impact I think that had on our whole country.
Yes, yes.
So tell me about that now. Okay, that was what, 1977?
Oh, yeah. No, don't whip me, don't whip me. Yasa Masa.
You still remember your lines?
You know, yes, I do. You know, I remember I was playing Las Vegas, and a gentleman came back. This white gentleman comes back, and he says, hello, Ben. He says, my name is Vereen. And I looked at him and said, yeah? He said, yes. I said, well, you can't have me back. You lost the war. You can't have me back. I tell you, the reason why I wanted to do Roots is when I was growing up in Brooklyn, there was one paragraph. You was a slave, and you weren't even thought in your parents' mind. You were a slave, and Lincoln freed you. And so unless you went on to college and demanded in those days that black studies, you didn't know much about the African-American Holocaust. So when Alex Haley and his brilliance went back to Gambia and went over to Jufere and found this all this history out about his family and wrote this, got on a steamer, and slept in the hull of the ship and came back across the country and wrote this wonderful book, it was on.
Well, you
it
know, it made us all feel like those people.
Well,
it
you
did.
Know.
Like, I remember our family sitting there. I remember when they just had all of the talk about it, leading mm-hmm. up to it. Everyone yes. was talking about this is the first time this kind of story is going to be on television, mm-hmm. on top of the fact it was the first time mm-hmm. you had a miniseries like that. So everyone was excited. Were you all excited like that?
Did you know it was?
We didn't know. I did, as I said, we didn't know. It wasn't the fact of, yes, ABC, God bless you, but they had the courage to do this piece. But we weren't thinking that. We weren't thinking, wow, this is going to win a lot of Emmys, and I'm going to be a big old star. Everybody's going to want me, and I'm going to be, oh, man, yes, I'll do Roots. No, I wanted to do Roots because of the document, because we needed, you see, look, Hitler in his madness, in his insanity, filmed everything. He filmed the Jews' Holocaust. He filmed them being killed.
Whoa.
There were no filming of the Black Holocaust.
Yeah.
It was all word of mouth. And here we had a chance to put it, some sort of idea what it was like on film. Mm.
And to put us into those characters.
Exactly.
To make us feel what they were feeling. And exactly. To make us love and honor those people.
Yes, and here's the thing, though. What are we going to do about it today?
That's a question.
That's a question.
What are we going to do about it today? Because we are in a place where it looks like we're going divided, but we need to remember we are United States of America. Mm-hmm. And united we stand, divided we fall. We've all contributed to this wonderful country.
Oh, you are so right. One more question. Always my last question. What's your life lesson, Ben?
My life lesson?
What is your life lesson that you can pass on?
Live it. Life is good. Take time to be still and know that the brilliance or the greatness that you're seeking is seeking you. Even in those moments where it looks like life has fallen down through the cracks, there's something, there's a power, there's a spirit, there's a God, a Allah, a Buddha, a Elohim, Jesus to help lift you up. Trust in that truth, that faith, and that will carry you through. Even when your human mind tells you you can't, and your human mind is programmed to do that.
Wow.
Oh, Ben, you are so inspiring.
And makes sense why you have made it from, you know, that was in the 70s to now, still acting and performing and doing what you love.
And more to come.
Yeah. And more to come.
Thank you so much.
Watch Sneaky Pete on Amazon and Making History on the Fox Channel.
Can't wait to see it. Thank you, Ben.
We all got a lot more to come.
Yes, we do. And we'll be right back.